Hi guys, welcome back. So spring is around the corner, and what else is there to do besides to paint some cherry blossom scenery? So today I'll be showing you how to paint this lovely postcard size cherry blossoms. And yeah, this is a really simple and fun one to paint. So grab your brushes and paints and let's get started. Okay, so I already have this painting all sketched, and then I've taped this down onto an acrylic board. And we are ready to paint. So if you like to paint along, feel free to pause right now and copy this sketch. So here you can see that these are the faraway mountains, and then we have these longer branches here, which are the cherry blossom trees, and then these trees go far away into the distance, and then we have this road coming to the front, and then we have a lake here. All right, and then one thing to take note while sketching out the trees, if you look closely at the reference photo, for the trees which are closer, the branch comes out higher on top here, so this will be the branch which will be closer to the viewer's eye. And then as we move towards the back, the branch will start slightly lower down, coming down here, going up, and then for the even further behind trees, the branch will start lower as we go further behind, and then we start lower downwards. So just to give you an idea how to sketch the trees according to its distance, we start from the top for the closest and then move down for the trees further behind. So yeah, this is our sketch, and then before we start, I'm just going to lighten this a little so it doesn't appear under the painting. Okay, and then let me share with you the colors that we'll be using. So let's look at this painting here that I've done earlier. For the cherry blossom trees, I'm using alizarin crimson. I have this lovely pink here. Okay, and then we have the grounds, lovely greens. I'll be using sap green. And then for the trees, we will have burnt umber and a darker brown. I'm using sepia. All right, and for the skies, I'll be using ultramarine blue, very very light wash. And then for the faraway mountains, this one's here, I'll be mixing a little bit of this alizarin crimson into this blue. And then we get this nice soft purple, and I'll be using this for the mountains and then for some of the grounds here as well. Okay, so let's start. So we start with the skies, and then we'll move down to the mountains, and then we'll fill in the foreground. So I'm using a larger mop brush for the background. So yep, we'll be using this light wash of blue to paint in the skies. And I'm going to leave out this area here because we're going to paint these trees. So just like that. And then wash off the blues. I'm going to just drag this a little down here. And then next, going into that purple. Okay, and here I'm going to lift my board up to have it flow downwards. And then paint this in these faraway mountains. And then here we have these faraway cherry blossom trees. So I'm going to just blend that out with water. Okay, let's bring this down. Okay, for this area, just with water, just going to blend it out. Soften the edges. Okay, and here we have some greens coming in already, so let's bring that in. So I'm going to switch over to sap green. Okay, and then just with water, let's blend out this area. I'm using a clean brush to do that. And then here, let's play around. Give some textures. And I'm going to add some shadows around here under the trees. So I'll probably mix in a little bit of ultramarine blue into that sap green to give a darker hue. And then just add it in like so. Then here, I'll start adding in the trees. Okay, and then we have some greens over here as well. So let's do that. Okay, and then I'm switching over to this purple here, but adding more blue into the mixture. This color here, I've mixed in a little bit of brown as well to make it slightly grayish. You can see on the reference picture we have some stones. Okay, and then I'm going to leave a gap in between. So you leave this white line in between to show that shape of a bank, like a river bank coming in. Okay, so we're just laying out the first layer for the painting, and then let's go in with some browns to paint in some shadows. Okay, and I'm going to fill this up with the same color as the skies. You can see that I'm using all really light and soft colors. Maybe darken here a little bit. Okay, and then it's going to splatter a little here. for the road, let's just draw some lines, some details. Then using dry brush, just press down your brush like this. Okay. And before this dries completely, I'm going to add some more details. Okay, so we are done with our first layer, and then I'll let this dry. And I think we can start working on the cherry blossom tree. So let's mix up a good amount of alizarin crimson onto your palette. And I'm using back my bigger brush, because we'll be painting a larger area. Okay, so we will paint bigger brush strokes around the left, and then as we gradually move out to the right, we start to paint smaller brush strokes. And if it's your first time painting a tree, I have another tutorial showing exactly step by step how to paint a cherry blossom tree. If you're interested, do check it out. Okay, so let's start on the left. And while doing this, I'm also leaving some white gaps in between. And just filling up the entire space. And then you can see I'm doing like a V-shaped crisscross, left, right, up, down. Don't want to paint in the same direction like this. We want it to change the direction. Okay, and then we have this cherry blossom trees further behind, going to the back. So let's do that. I'm going to dilute my colors a little more. And then pull this out into the distance. You can see it as it goes further, it becomes more blurry. So let's make it lighter, and then I'll let it end around here. Let's darken it a little bit more. Okay, and then let's keep going with this. As we start to come out, I'm going to make the brush stroke smaller, and I'm going to paint around these branches. Have the leaves coming out of this branch, like so. And then feel free to also study the reference photo and see how the leaves twist and turn, how the branches twist and turn. You can see this one coming down like that. Then we have some coming out. So yeah, before you start painting, do feel free to study the reference photo to get an idea how the trees turn, twist and turn, because that will help a lot when you start painting. Okay, and I think I'm done with this part, and we'll fill in the branches. Before that, let's darken this area a little more. So I'm going to pick up more paints and then add in some shadows. So we're going to do this before it completely dries out. Okay, I'm going to lift this up to let the paints flow. Okay, Okay, and then for these areas, I'm going to just cover it, pull the colors down just with water to fill out the white gaps. Okay, so we are done with the first layer for our cherry blossom, and I'm going to leave it to dry. And while waiting, I'll probably start working on our foreground here, adding more details. So in the reference photo, we can see that there's a bit of tree branches around here. And I think I'm not going to paint that in because it will distract our painting from the main subject, which is the cherry blossom. So I'll just paint some smaller wild grass around here. Okay, so this area is pretty dry enough for me to start working on the tree. So let's go in. I'm going to start with this really long one that you can see in the reference photo. I'm just going to follow along that. And then we want to keep the branch as crooked or as curvy as it looks. That will help to give more movement and life into the tree. And the tip is to leave that gap in between the lines to paint out broken lines for the tree branch. And then coming out, I'm switching over to liner brush for the smaller lines. Towards the end, feel free to just fling out the lines like this. That will help to make it look more natural. Can see that I am drawing it with my wrist above the table, only resting my arm here. That will give more movement when you're drawing out the lines. And then try holding it towards the back of your brush to also give more movement. Instead of holding it close to the tip, it will give you more control but less movement. That's not what we want. We want more movement, more freedom. And here I'm using dark brown sepia. You can see that this pinks that we applied earlier starts to make more sense after we draw in the branches. Okay, and then we have some coming out here. Let's do another one. And then another thing to take note is that the branches started out pretty thick, and then as we move from left to right, it will get thinner in the lines. And then instead of starting from the frame on this side, I'll start from here, which is the tree, which is slightly further behind. So do take note when you're doing this by working from upwards downwards as you paint the branch, and then moving from left to right as we move into the distance. By doing so, it will help to create the distance and depth for the trees. Okay, and we are done with the branches. So now it's time to top up a second layer for the pinks. So I'm going back in, getting more alizarin crimson. This time I'm going for a thicker mixture. Okay, and then I'm going to paint around the trunks. Sorry, I'm going to paint around the branches. So I'm going to add in some here. Try to think of like doing a V shape like that, a V shape. And then some smaller ones. And then towards the end, the strokes get smaller like that. And then try to follow the movement of the branches. For example, if it's coming down, we'll have the strokes facing, flowing downwards like that. Like having coming down like that. Okay, and then let's add some smaller splatters around here. And using a liner brush, and create smaller splatters. They will look like some petals falling down. Okay, we're almost done. Let's do the tree trunks. Okay. Okay, so I've given it a quick dry, and for the final bit, let's bring in some of the highlights. So I'm going to use this white gouache. And let's bring back some highlights around here. So I'm just going to dab in like so, where around the darkest areas. Just like painting in the petals. Okay, and then for the rest, just going to splatter it in like so, and then some around here. Alright, so we are done with our painting, and this is what it looks like. And here's to give you a close-up on this scenery. And yeah, we've used a lot of pinks and purplish blues for the mountain backgrounds to achieve this overall soft and lovely spring scenery. And if you enjoyed this tutorial, I have more similar spring tutorials available up on the spring playlist. Do take a look. And I'd like to share with you some of the paintings that we've done. So in the spring playlist, this is one of the videos you'll be able to see. This is a scenery in Paris, of course, with the Eiffel Tower. And I've shown the entire process video of this. And then we have another spring scenery. This is available on my Patreon. A slightly different scenery where we painted lots of purples and blues for these trees, and we have a nice river as well, a lake. And then I also have a mini tutorial for this on Patreon where I show how to paint these cherry blossom flowers up close with this bouquet dreamy background. That will be a mini bonus tutorial. And then another painting that I've done is this one here. This is also available on Patreon. The full process of the painting is there. So if you're interested, go head on over and take a look. And yeah, that's all from me today. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. If you painted along, do tag me on Instagram. I'd love to see and share your works. Otherwise, guys, happy painting, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!